sworn into office. He was required by Article 2 of the Constitution of the United States of America to preserve, to take an oath to preserve, protect, and defend that very Constitution.
Yes.
Brothers and sisters, what we have today is nothing less than a hijacking of our democracy, and we are here to say that we will not stand for that.
Shameful!
The president and his administration are waging an assault on the United States Constitution. They are promoting war in our names. They are telling us that we must be at war with Iraq to protect our safety, while at the same time, they are rejecting Iraq's offer to allow UN weapons inspectors back into the country. They are telling us that we must accept policies that directly undermine and contradict many of our constitutional amendments, including the 4th, 5th, 6th amendments. Read our Constitution. They are telling us that they are pushing forward policies that allow for people to be detained without charge or access to legal counsel, as you heard Peggy Thompson talk about. They are pushing forward policies that allow for secret hearings and for a program that seeks to turn our mail carriers and truck drivers into citizen spies. They are telling us that we should allow the American system of justice, which presumes that individuals are innocent until proven guilty, to be turned on its head. Do you believe them?
No.
Tell me again, do you believe them?
No.
Are you willing to sacrifice the fundamental rights guaranteed to each and every one of us through our great Constitution to further the private political agenda of George W. Bush and his administration?
No.
Is this the America that you believe in?
No.
This morning, the Seattle PI reprinted President Bush's most recent national security strategy of the United States. I ask each of you, if you have not already done so, to please, please, please read this document. In each of our names, this document sets forth a strategy that establishes America as a supreme superpower able to attack countries preemptively in the name of defending us, you and me, the people of the United States of America, with clear disregard for any United Nations conventions to which we are signatories that require America to take its place as one of many nations in the world who seek to exist together and with great regard for each other's sovereignty. What do we say to this?
No!
We say not in our names! At the Hate Free Zone campaign of Washington, we are getting multiple calls each day from people who are being detained, who are being harassed, who are being visited by the FBI. 2 weeks ago on September 21st, over 1,100 people came together at Town Hall. Many of you were there. Thank you so much for being there. People came to hear the personal testimonies, like Peggy Ujamaa's story, of Muslims, of Somalis, of Arabs, of Latinos, of Sikhs, of so many people who have been the targets of the government profiling and harassment. Somali women streamed in by the hundreds. They were wearing hijabs and interpreter headsets so that they could understand the process and participate in our democracy, perhaps for the first time, and we celebrate those people. They sat next to Sikh men who have been victims of hate since September 11th simply because of the turbans they wear. They listened to stories of Latino workers who have been victims of airport raids and employment discrimination, workers who have given their blood and sweat to this country to build it and to do jobs that nobody else will do. They listened to Arab Americans and Muslims whose families have been in detention for 6 to 8 months without charges. these people came in spite of great fear because they understand, as you do because you are here today, that the situation is urgent. We are talking about life and death here. Congress is convening and will be voting by October 18th, according to Jim McDermott. We don't have much time. The House is going to vote on Thursday, and then it's going to go to the Senate because it's going to pass the House. So we need you to act, and I thank you for being here. We are talking, as I said, about life and death. Death of the men, women, and children who will be certain casualties of the war in Iraq. Death of the dreams of immigrants to be safe from persecution that they came to this country to escape. And death, brothers and sisters, of each of your constitutional and civil rights. Attorney General John Ashcroft said in a Senate hearing in December that those who oppose his policies and the policies of the Bush administration are aiding and abetting terrorism. We reject this. The people who speak out do so because they love America and because they believe that public debate and dissension is essential for a functioning democracy. They speak out for freedom for their children and for all of our children. And they speak out because they know that ultimately the erosion of any one of these rights can summarily be applied to all of us. We cannot build happy lives on a ground polluted by violence. This is a defining moment in the life of our country, and I ask that each of you be actively involved in the next few weeks in standing up for the true America. We will either take our place in the family of nations as seekers of peace and justice, or we will continue on this terrible road to war. And each one of us can make a difference. It is up to us now to take our wisdom and to spread it. We must be as unstoppable as a roaring river that rushes over rocks until the edges are dulled. We must be omnipresent like the whispering of winds through trees in a forest. And we must be strong in our beliefs and effusive in our joy. We must stand together, our feet rooted in the ground and our head planted in the dreams of what is possible. Each one of you by being here is brave and strong, and I am proud, very, very proud to be standing for nothing less than our freedom and the Constitution of the United States of America. Yeah. Thank you.